Good morning, students. How are you? Hope all of you are fine. Albita, today's lecture is in the continuation of the previous chapter that we were discussing, and name of the chapter is Industrial Revolution. Beta, in this in yesterday's lecture, I discussed about the women, children, and industrialization. That what role was played by the women and children in the industrialization, and what were the consequences of the industrialization on the women and children. But in previous lecture, we discussed that a high number of women and children, they were recruited in the textile industry. But beta, there were these children, they were employed in the coal mines also. So today we will start the child labor in the coal mines. Beta, like we know that coal mines, these are the dangerous places to work, as sometime these coal mines, these are flooded with water, sometime there is explosion. So this is a very dangerous place to work, and these, the owner of the coal mines, they use children to reach in the deep mines or wherever the place was narrower. As we know, the built of children, that is lean, so that is why these children, they were able to enter in that narrower area of coal mines also, where adult could not reach. So this was the reason. That is why these coal owners, they employed children in the coal mines. And even these younger children, they worked as trappers. Trappers means who opened and shut the doors as the coal wagons travel through mines. And even sometimes they carried heavy loads of coal on their back also, and they were known as the coal bearers. So this way, these children, they worked as trappers or as the coal bearers. And even these factory managers, now what were the reason? What reasons were given by these factory managers that why were they employing these children in their factories? The reason were that it is very important to train the children, as they will be the future worker in their factories. And even the evidence in the British factory records reveal that half of the factory workers, they started working in the age less than 10, and afterward even the 28% when they were under the age of 14. So even women, whether women, they became self-dependent because they were working in the factories, but the term of work, those were very much humiliating for them. As we have read that even sometime that severe punishments were also given to them. And even children, they lost at birth or in the early childhood, and even they are to live in the urban slums. That was very congested area, and there was an acute shortage of basic facilities like sanitation, housing, and clean drinking water. So then also these people, they were forced to work in the factories because they didn't have any option. Because of the larger land estate, now they became jobless. So this was the reason why women and children, they were employed in the factories, in the textile industries, as well as in the coal mines. So as we have discussed that there were so many consequences, so many negative impacts on the women and children of the industrialization. But whenever there is a bad impact, so it creates protest in the society. So the next topic is about the protest movements. As we know, beta, this topic we are starting from, we have taken one example from the French Revolution, as you have read in class 9 also. Beta, in the French Revolution, different ideas came up in the society. those were liberty, equality and fraternity, which showed the path for the massive action for protest. अब जो ये ideas थे बेटा हमारे liberty, equality and fraternity, it gives a foundation, it provided a base for the protest movements. Even both in creating democratic institution as well as in the society. So beta, the working population agitated for the right to vote. As we know, in France their society was divided in three categories: noble, clergy and third estate, and all the work burden as well as the financial burden, it was on the third estate, right? So, and they didn't have any right to vote. So now this working population, they protested to get the right to vote. The government reacted by repression just to suppress them, and by new laws that denied people the right to protest. So even at that time, like England had been at war with France for a very long time. Trade between England and Europe disrupted. Factories were forced to shut down. Unemployment increased and the price of essential items were also high. Now, Parliament, it passed two combination acts which banned the unauthorized public meetings. And even people, they didn't have any right to express their speech or to give their views by writing. It means they established censorship. There was a complete control of government on the print media. So these protests, this was against the old corruption. This term was used. What do we mean by old corruption? Because this word is associated with the social system. Like noble and clergy, these two orders, they have the right by their birth. They had the privileges by their birth. So they opposed to giving the working population the right to vote. As we know, no one wanted to give their right to anyone else, right? So they supported the corn laws. Abhi, what do we mean by this corn laws? Beta, it prevented the import of cheaper food until prices in Britain had risen to a certain level. अब जो ये corn law था, ये क्या था बेटा? इसमें क्या था? That they cannot import the food items till the prices of the food items it reach a certain level. After that, they were allowed to import food items. And even as workers, just because of industrialization, now the workers flooded towns and factories. They expressed their anger and frustration in the numerous ways. Like sometimes there were bread or food riots throughout the country, as bread was the staple food in the diet of the poor. And if the price of bread rose high, then it has a very negative, poor impact on the standard of poor people. So that is why such riots were particularly frequent in the worst year of the war, 1795. Now, another cause of this hardship, it was the process known as enclosure. Beta, in this, hundreds of small farms had been merged into the larger ones of the powerful landlords. In this, beta, small lands, those were joined together, those were collectivized, so that farm machinery can be used on those land to increase the production. But poor rural families, they were affected by this. As the introduction of machines in the cotton industry threw thousands of handloom weavers out of work. So beta, these machines, these industrial changes, these new inventions, these were not liked by the poor people. So they destroyed the power looms, which they believed had destroyed their livelihood. Even there was a resistance on the introduction of machines in the woolen knitting industry. बेटा जो woolen knitting industry होती है, पहले उसमें क्या सब hand से knitting करते थे, But after the invention of these woolen knitting industry, so there was also protest against these. After that, shearing frames were destroyed by croppers. As you know that this shearing frame, these were used to shear sheep by hand. जो वूल रिमूव किया जाता है शीप से वो बाय हैंड किया जाता था. सो बट आफ्टर दिस शियरिंग फ्रेम्स वर इंट्रोड्यूस, नाउ दिस वर्क वाज आल्सो स्टार्टेड बाय हैंड बाय मशीन्स. एंड इवन सम थ्रेशर्स, दीज फार्म लेबरर्स, दे वर वेरी मच थ्रेटन्ड बाय द कंबाइंड हार्वेस्टर और न्यू थ्रेशिंग मशीन्स. थ्रेशिंग बेटा क्या होता है, इट इज अ प्रोसेस टू सेपरेट द ग्रेन फ्रॉम द हस्क, right? So now this work they started doing by threshers. So now they need less number of laborers. So that is why these threshers, these were also opposed by the farm laborers. Now these writers, these protesters, between 9 of them, they were hanged and 450 were sent to Australia as a punishment. So and this movement, it was known as Luddism, Luddism, and because this was started by General Ned Ludd. Now its participant, the protestant of this protest, they demanded a minimum wage, control over the labor of women and children, work for those who had lost their jobs because of the coming of machinery. Now this protest movement, it was against the machine era, as now they want, they demanded a minimum wage, they want the good working conditions, and they demanded that the workers who had lost their jobs just because of these industrialization, they should get job. So this way, and even they demanded the right to form the trade unions so that they could legally present their demand early, because at till that time they were not allowed to protest because the censorship was there. They were not allowed to express their ideas. And during the early years of industrialization, the working population possessed neither the vote nor the legal methods to express their anger because they were not allowed to protest. And even there was not any law that favored them, like Minimum Wages Act was not there, labor laws were not there. So that is why 80,000 people, they gathered peacefully at St. Peter's Field in Manchester just to claim the democratic rights, that they should also have the right to express their views. And do you know that this protest, this was known as the Peter Rule. And there they were suppressed brutally, which became to be known as the Peter Rule. And after that, they demanded, their all their demands were denied. Then they extended, these extended the restrictions on political activity. After that, after Peter Rule, after this massive massacre, they need to make the House of Commons more representative, was recognized by liberal political groups. Because this liberal political group was, it was that they wanted equal rights for all. That is why they were known as the liberal political group. And they demanded the same democratic rights, equal democratic rights for all. So this way these protest movements was started after this phase of industrialization. So this was the topic about the protest movement. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the reforms, that which reforms took place after these protests, or which laws were formed after these protests. Hope all of you have understood the topic. Thank you and have a nice day.